I must say, I think that the atmosphere has changed substantially after the April election. So whereas before, I really believe us to be in an era of a world-class media freedom, if you look back on where we come from and where we're at now. But I see the rhetoric around the media hotting up quite a bit. So within 1 month after the installation of a new administration, we had two marches on media houses against things they had chosen to publish. Now, you may well say, as some of my colleagues do, that that's fair game. We hit hard, therefore we must expect action back. But in fact, when it's the governing party which does those things, it has an inhibiting effect on the media. I think we're kind of midpoint through our revolution, where audiences leave you as a printed product for ways that are easier for them to read. I'm sure if you look at ourselves, we consume media on our phones. My tablet here is how I get most of my media. I still read 7 or 8 newspapers a day because I'm a newspaper editor. I've learned not to get paranoid about these things, is that actually all you've got to do is produce good journalism and then put it out on the platforms that people want to read and find out how they want to read it. I think some things that have been lost in the course of this revolution, specialization for one, and honestly I find our readers don't have the stomach for 4,000 word pieces any longer. You've got to break up information. I think what we've seen, like we've seen all over the world, is the loss of specialization, beat reporting. I think it's really terrible that in South Africa, with our kind of labor market, that we don't have that grouping of specialized labor reporters you had to have when I was a young journalist. I think you see it across sectors. You don't have sector specialists any longer. In health and education, thank God, you do have specialist journalists in those two important areas. But I think as newsrooms have gotten tighter, smaller, the instinct is to have the generalists rather than the specialists. And as an editor, I find this constant balancing act between ensuring that you've got your whole country covered, it's a very big country, and that you've got every single sector well covered. I've been editing for 10 years now at two different titles. I think once I've achieved certain goals that I still need to at City Press, I'd really like to try the new world of journalism, which is digital. I'm also really interested that the best journalism is happening in the non-profit sector. So if you look at the Mail and Guardians, Amabungani, it's health reporting. If you look at largely European and American models, also some rest of African models, I do think that the next great journalism is going to happen philanthropically or by funds, people who still believe in the craft, and probably I'll end up in that sphere.